Good evening. Tonight we celebrate the 20th Sunday in Ordinary Time. Please stand for our opening song, All Are Welcome. Let us build a house where love can dwell and all can safely live. A place where saints and children tell how hearts learn to forgive. Built of hopes and dreams and visions, rock of faith and vault of grace. Here the love of Christ shall end division. All are welcome, all are welcome, all are welcome in this place. Let us build a house where prophets speak and words are strong and true. Where all God's children dare to seek to dream God's reign anew. Here the cross shall stand as witness and as symbol of God's grace. Here as one we claim the faith of Jesus. All are welcome, all are welcome, all are welcome in this place.
Testing. Here we go. All right. One of the things that we're going to do a little different this evening is we will do communion at the regular time. And so once you receive communion, just go back to your seat. Then we'll have the closing prayer and announcements and dismissal. The only thing I would caution you at the end of Mass, when we're ready to leave, that not everyone gets up at the same time and heads for the door. We want to avoid congestion. So the ushers would kind of usher everybody out like they do for communion so that we don't have everybody crowding through the door at the same time. So let's begin in the name of the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And the grace and peace of God our Father and the love of the Lord Jesus be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
And as we approach these sacred mysteries and we prepare to hear God's word and to share at the Eucharistic table, we call to mind our sins and ask God's mercy. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting. And let us pray. O God, who have prepared for those who love you good things which no eye can see, fill our hearts with the warmth of your love, so that loving you in all things and above all things, we may attain your promises, which surpass every human desire. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, observe what is right, do what is just, for my salvation is about to come, my justice about to be revealed. The foreigners who join themselves to the Lord, ministering to him, loving the name of the Lord, and becoming his servants, all who keep the Sabbath free from profanation and hold to my covenant, them I will bring to my holy mountain and make joyful in my house of prayer. Their burnt offerings and sacrifices will be acceptable on my altar, for my house shall be called a house of prayer for all peoples. The word of the Lord.
Let all the nations praise you. O God, let all the nations praise you. May God have pity on us and bless us. May he let his face shine upon us. So may your way be known upon earth, among all nations, your salvation. O God, let all the nations praise. May the nations be glad and exult, because you rule the peoples in equity. The nations on earth you guide. O God, let all the nations praise. May the peoples praise you, O God. May all the peoples praise you. May God bless us, and may all the ends of the earth fear him. O God, let all the nations praise you.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, I am speaking to you Gentiles, inasmuch as I am the apostle to the Gentiles. I glory in my ministry in order to make my race jealous and thus save some of them. For if their rejection is the reconciliation of the world, what will their acceptance be but life from the dead? For the gifts and the call of God are irrevocable. Just as you once disobeyed God, but have now received mercy because of their disobedience, so they have now disobeyed in order that, by virtue of the mercy shown to you, they too may now receive mercy. For God delivered all to disobedience, that he might have mercy upon all. The word of the Lord.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Jesus proclaimed the gospel of the kingdom and cured every disease among the people. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. At that time, Jesus withdrew to the region of Tyre and Sidon. And behold, a Canaanite woman of the district came and called out, "Have pity on me, O son of David. My daughter is tormented by a demon." But Jesus did not say a word in answer to her. Jesus' disciples came and asked him, "Send her away, for she keeps calling out after us." He said in reply, "I was sent only to the lost sheep of the house of Israel." But the woman came and did Jesus homage, saying, "Lord, help me." He said in reply, "It is not right to take the food of the children and throw it to the dogs." She said, "Please, Lord, for even the dogs eat the scraps that fall from the table of their masters." Then Jesus said to her in reply, "O woman, great is your faith. Let it be done for you as you wish." And the woman's daughter was healed from that hour. The Gospel of the Lord. It seems there was a deacon whose sermons were very long and boring. And it was announced in the church on a Sunday that he had been transferred to a different parish. And that it was Jesus' wish, he said, that he leave that week. Well, the choir director got up and said, "We will now sing song number 222, What a Friend We Have in Jesus." I like this gospel. It is a gospel of hope. It's a gospel of faith. And you have to keep in mind that in this gospel, Cana had been conquered by Israel, and they were considered dogs. Years ago in Illinois, a young man with 6 months of schooling ran for the legislature. He lost. Next, he entered into business and failed, and it took him 17 years to pay back for his worthless partner. He became engaged to a young lady, and she died. He had a serious breakdown, ran for Congress, and was defeated. He became a vice presidential candidate and lost, and 2 years later was defeated for senator. He ran once more for office and was elected. And yes, that man was Abraham Lincoln. It took Winston Churchill 3 years to get through eighth grade because he couldn't pass English. And yet, he was one of the most inspiring speakers during World War II. And later, when he was asked to get the commencement speech at Oxford University, his now famous speech was only three words: "Never give up." So what has all this to do with the story in chapter 15 about the Canaanite woman? You see, if you read the text closely, you see that she was refused three times by Jesus before he granted her request. Finally, the fourth time, Jesus said, "Woman, you have great faith. Let your wish be granted." And from that moment on, her daughter was well. It reminds me of Saint Monica, who had three children: Navigius, who was a good one; Perpetua, who became a nun and ran a convent; and Augustine, who lived a wild life for over 20 years. His mother prayed for his change. And finally, one day, he began to study the New Testament and St. Paul. And Bishop Ambrose baptized him. 20 years his mother prayed for him. St. Augustine went on to become a priest at age 36, a bishop at 41, and was a bishop for 35 years. It was said that the rosary beads of St. Monica, his mother, were round when she started and flat after she finished praying for him. There are more quotations from St. Augustine's in the Catechism than any other reader. And all of this is due to persistent prayer of his mother. Monica, like the Canaanite woman, received many refusals during those 20 years praying for Augustine's conversion. The Canaanite woman persisted in prayer before God. And we ask, why did Jesus not answer her prayer sooner? Why leave her in agony for so long, for 20 years? Why? Why me? I've often asked God why my mother had Alzheimer's. Why did I have cancer or kidney dialysis? Why do people die? I don't have the answers to the questions. Suffering is a mystery, and we don't have the full answer to it, only bits and pieces for the answer. Peter, in the first reading, tells us that our faith is proved through trials. Think of how St. Monica strengthened and matured over 20 years of praying for her son. I think of how my mother prayed every night with the rosary hanging from her bed. I don't know whether it was just for me or the other six of us, but it took a lot of prayers. Another bit and piece, the answer is that we believe that for someone of faith, things eventually work together. Paul in Romans 8 writes, "By turning everything to their good, God cooperates with all those who love him." And we endure trials and viruses, and we're asked to have faith like the Canaanite woman and Saint Monica. We should not lose hope or give up, but persist in prayer so that we may hear the same words of Jesus: "You have great faith. Let your wish be granted." In Isaiah 43, it says, "Thus says Yahweh, who created you, who formed you, do not be afraid, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by name. You are mine. Should you pass through the water, I will be with you. Or through rivers, they will not swallow you up. Should you walk through fire, you will not suffer, and the flame will not burn you. It seems to me that Jesus is reminding us through the Canaanite woman to have faith, to believe in the power of prayer, and turn to God in need.
Let us stand now and offer our petitions, these prayers, knowing that each day we need to turn to the Lord, seeking His help.
For the grace of perseverance, that God will strengthen us in this time of conflict and division, so that we may remain faithful disciples, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may all work to eliminate racism and discrimination in all of its forms, so that all may be treated with dignity and welcomed and included in our church and society, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For teachers, staff, administrators, and students, as they begin this school year, that all may be kept safe from harm and each child have the opportunity to grow in wisdom and faith, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace in our cities, that the Holy Spirit will guide every heart to work untiringly to end violence and promote safety, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are in need, the homeless, the sick, and those with addictions or mental illness, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our own personal intentions. We pray to the Lord.
Lord. Come to you as did the Canaanite woman, seeking your assistance, Lord. We offer these prayers for those that we love, for the world that we live in, for blessings upon all. We make these prayers through Christ our Lord.
By faith and not by sight, nor gracious words we hear of him who spoke as none e'er spoke, but we believe him near. We may not touch his hand and side, nor follow where he trod, yet in his promise we rejoice and cry, my Lord and God. Help then, O Lord, our unbelief, and may our faith abound to call on you when you are near and and seek where you are found. That when our life of faith is done in realms of clearer light, we may behold you as you are in full and endless sight. We walk by faith and not by sight, nor gracious words we hear of him who spoke as none e'er spoke, but we believe him near.
Pray with me now that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept us for the praise of the Lord. Receive our offerings, O Lord, by which is brought about a glorious exchange, that by offering given we may merit to receive your very self through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts and let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you laid the foundations of the world and have arranged the changing of times and seasons. You formed us in your own image and set humanity over the whole world in all its wonder, to rule in your name over all you have made, and forever praise you in your mighty works through the Lord Jesus. And so with all the angels we praise you, as in celebration we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you. Your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be your name. For, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he took bread, and giving thanks, said the blessing. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the cup and he gave you thanks. He said the blessing. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." the mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, for you in this holy and living sacrifice, look upon the offerings of your church and reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of the Son become one body, one Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with blessed Mother, glorious martyrs, James, and with all constant life help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, that's the salvation, please to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church with your servant, Francis, our Pope, Michael, our Bishop, and all the clergy and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family coming before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, to whom you bestow on the world all that is good. To him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Together in praying the prayer that Jesus himself has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our day, that by the help of your mercy we may be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope of the Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now. And Lord Jesus, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but look upon the faith of your church, and graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever." The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Sins of the world, grant us peace.
This is the Lamb of God, Jesus, who takes away our sins. Blessed are we who share at the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body of Christ bring us to everlasting life.
Caritas est vera, Deus ibi est, the love of Christ joins us together, let us rejoice in him, and in our love and care for all. Now love God in return. Ubi caritas est vera, Deus ibi est, Deus ibi est. True communion, let us gather. May all division cease, and in their place be Christ the Lord, our risen Prince of Peace. Ubi caritas est vera, est vera. Deus ibi est, Deus ibi est. May we who gather at this table to share the bread of life become a sacrament of love, your healing touch, O Christ. Ubi caritas est vera, Deus ibi est, Deus ibi est. For those in need, make us your mercy. For those oppressed, your might. Make us your church a holy sign of justice and new life. Ubi caritas.
caritas es vera, Deus ibi est, Deus ibi est. May we one day behold your glory and see you face to face, rejoicing with the saints of God to sing eternal praise. Ubi caritas est vera, Deus ibi est, Deus ibi est.
Let us pray. Made partakers of Christ through these sacraments, we humbly implore your mercy, Lord, that conformed to this, to his image on earth, we may one day share a place in heaven, who lives and reigns forever and ever. I want you to know there is a change in the Mass schedule this week because school is starting, and so there will be a Mass on Tuesday at 12:10, Wednesday at 8:20, and Thursday at 7 p.m., and Friday at 8:20. That's a.m. If you look at the bulletin, it says 8:20 p.m. Friday. No, it's 8 in the morning, 8:20 in the morning. School will begin on Monday. There'll be a dismissal at 11:30. And I just remind you again as we leave this evening to kind of wait for the to be dismissed by the usher so we go out without crowding. Thank you. The Lord be with you, and may Almighty God bless us, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Thanks be to God.
All the ends of the earth, all you creatures of the sea, lift up your eyes to the wonders of the Lord. For the Lord of the earth, the master of the sea, has come with justice for the Lord. Break into song at the deeds of the Lord, the wonders God has done in every age. All the ends of the earth, all you creatures of the sea, lift up your eyes to the wonders of the Lord. For the Lord of the earth, the master of the sea, has come with justice for the Lord. Heaven and earth shall rejoice in his might. Every heart, every nation call him Lord. All the ends of the earth, all you creatures of the sea, lift up your eyes to the wonders of the Lord. For the Lord of the earth, the master of the sea, has come with justice for the world. The Lord has made salvation known. faithful to the promises of old. Let the ends of the earth, let the sea and all it holds, make music before our King. All the ends of the earth, all you creatures of the sea, lift up your eyes to the wonders of the Lord, for the Lord of the earth, the master of the sea, has come with justice for the world.